Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Animal Crossing New Horizons. Thank you, everybody, for the continued support here on the series. It has been unbelievable with how many people have been coming over and watching the Animal Crossing series. Thank you all very much for that. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing as well. Today, we're going to be doing a little bit of a different, it's more of like, a laid-back episode here. For those of you who have been watching the Isaac series, you know that I've been kind of sick for the last couple of days here, but I'm feeling better today than I was yesterday, and I just now noticed that there's not only a longhorn citrus beetle here, but there's also a tarantula in the background, which, of course, we're gonna we're gonna need to get a little bit of revenge on old sissy here. This is not sissy, but there we go. Yeah, so if you catch up to a tarantula fast enough, you can actually get them in the net while they hop up and they're about to charge you. So that's what I did there. But yeah, today I'm going to do a little bit of planning. I'm definitely going to do a mystery island as well. I thought I had Flick on my island again today, but apparently not. I could have swore that I saw him earlier. I did log on this morning to get turnips, as you can plainly see here, and I may have gone a little overboard with the turnips. I had to move a couple things in the house, obviously because I didn't have any space. And I'll let you see how many I bought. We got some turnips. I made a couple of light purchases. I mean, it's not like I spent all the money I had on turnips and putting all my eggs in one basket. I mean, who would ever do such a thing? No one. That's who. I tell you what, no accountant's ever gonna tell their own client to do that. No, it's you really shouldn't do that, because if you do, you know, you never know what kind of risk you're putting yourself in if you were to take all of your money and spend them in only one spot and one spot only. That is a very volatile and unpredictable market. Because, I mean, what kind of idiot would do that? Certainly not me. But yeah, I'm going to be planning on upgrading the island a little bit. A little bit more. I wouldn't say terraforming yet, because I don't have the terraform tool, and I also don't know how to get that tool yet. But I definitely want to plan out exactly where I want to put, like, stairs and inclines and stuff. Oh, hey, Bones, what's going on? You got your egg basket. I'm out for a walk, yes. This is yours. Yeah, I got you something. Something. Oh, wait, no, I didn't. Now I feel bad. Here, Bones. I got you covered, bro. Hang on. I actually did get you something. Looking good. Hey, yeah, vampire costume. Thank you very much. Yeah, I got it from somebody. Do you want this? It's yours. It's 30 stones. 30 of them. I actually only meant to give you one, but yeah, you can take 30, I guess. That's fine, too. Okay. Let's go talk to the Scammon twins while we're over here. But I did buy into turnips, obviously, as you plainly see, for 110 per, which is the maximum that you can buy in for, by the way. And I'm going to get rid of the spider, because apparently I don't have Flick on my island. Oh, I actually did give him only one. Well, good. Oh, enjoy the one stone. So we get 8,350 bells. 8,000 of that, by the way, is the tarantula, which is the reason why you want to be doing tarantula farming as often as possible whenever you can. But let's try to get a good idea of roughly where I want to have the inclines and the bridges here. Cash in my Nook Miles real quick. But it's been honestly really fun to see people's reaction to the Animal Crossing series and how many people have been picking up this awesome game, especially in the times that we're living in right now, at least the time it's recording anyway. You know, I think that Animal Crossing gives a very nice escape for a lot of people, and it's a blissful unique experience that you can share with your family and friends. Apparently, I planted a money tree here, and they have 10,000 bells in it. Okay. I don't remember planting that one, but it was probably one of those trees that, like, I planted a couple days ago and just forgot about. I have another golden spot here, which I'm going to immediately put 10,000 bells back into. There we go on that. Okay, so what do we need here in terms of infrastructure? I already have a northern bridge over right here. Also, apparently there's some weeds here. I definitely want to get a stairway here. Because I'm tired of getting, I'm tired of using my ladder, basically. I don't mind using the vaulting pole, but the ladder, for some reason, always feels more laborious. I definitely want to get a bridge here as well. I know that I have another bridge over, somewhere over here. But I definitely want to bridge all the rivers, and I want to get all the stairs, especially the stairs, going up here. And I want more than one per incline as well. I know with the terraforming tool, you have the capability of lowering or raising land and stuff. And I think that's cool and all, but like for me personally, oh, there's an Atlas moth here. For me personally, I don't really want to play. I don't want to edit the island too much. Halfway out of laziness, but also halfway because I think it's more fun to kind of play with what the game gave you in terms of the island spawn. But that's just me. That's not a knock on anyone who is. And I'm not necessarily saying that we're not going to terraform, like do some major terraforming on the island. But right now, I think it's more fun for me to be putting bridges and marks and stuff. Or not marks, but the stairs and stuff and ramps. That's great. Might as well just clean the trash out of the river, I guess. So let's see what kind of options we have from... Let's see what kind of options we have from Tom here and take a look at how many he'll actually grant us for... I don't know if you can do it one at a time or if you can do multiple ones. Hopefully you can do multiple ones. And also, hopefully, if I get a good price for turnips, I'll be able to pay off these immediately. Isabelle's apparently sleeping. It's only 9:27, Isabelle. Oh, Tom. Let's talk about infrastructure. Bridges and inclines. I would like to make an incline first. Okay, so all these are going to cost something. Now, I don't know if I have to actually pay for it now. If I do, then obviously we're going to have to wait. I went for a wooden stairway. I went for a wooden bridge. Yeah, something like that would be cool. But I also kind of like stone. Natural ramp is kind of eh. I don't know about that. It looks a little bit too tacky. I like the log staircase. For me, it's down to the log staircase or the stone staircase. I think the log staircase feels a little bit more natural, so let's go with that. Yes. Incline marker kit. Use it at the base of a cliff. Okay. Did he give it to me? Okay, yeah, he gave it to me. Okay, let's go see where we can put this incline here. I don't know if Tom is going to make me pay for this one first before we do another one. He probably will, knowing the game. But it can be a slow but general process. And I'm willing to put up with that. I mean, the ramps and inclines and bridges aren't that expensive. The bridges are more expensive than the inclines, I think. Okay, so I want to, before I put this incline here, I want to think of this from a natural perspective. Okay, so if this is, I mean, my house is right over here. So, like, if I'm starting my day, I'm going to go up and check all the, I'm going to check the inclines here. So I would obviously use that, and then that bridge, and honestly, I would want to put it, like, right here. Like somewhere where I don't have to walk that far away from my bridge, because I want to get up top as fast as possible. So I bet I probably can't place one at an angle here. This tree's probably gonna have to go as well. Maybe. Let's see what it says. I don't see an even stretch of cliffs where the incline would go. Yeah, so it has to be even. I could put one here, but I think that would obscure the waterfall there too much. So I'll probably have to put it here. Let me see what this looks like. It's gonna remove this tree, and that's fine. I wonder if it can be made here. I'm gonna be pretty adamant about making this incline pretty close to the bridge, if possible. It doesn't look like it's gonna be close to that bridge, so I'll put it on the corner here. I don't want it to be too flush with that face there. Let me see. Let me look at this again here. Yeah, that's better. That's better. It's a little bit narrow right here. It's a little bit narrow, so I'm hoping that... I can't even get past this right now. That's fun. It's a little bit narrow at that one little spot, so maybe when I get the terraforming tool, I'm gonna have to mess with that. But let's go back to Tom and let's see if I can build another one. He probably is not going to let me. Let's sell this tarantula real quick before the store closes. Yes, I want to sell more stuff. You can have the tarantula and the... Oh, yeah, I forgot we got an Atlas Moth. It'd be like 11,000, dude. Look at that. We're already back up to 41 Gs. That's a lot of turnips I could have bought. I mean, that's a lot of down payment I can use for my next infrastructure project. Yes, that'll do. That'll do nicely. We'll talk to Tom again. All right, hey, Tommy. We gotta talk. Let's talk about infrastructure. I would like to build another bridge or incline. As such, I'm not discussing other changes. Let's not build it. Shut it down. Talk about infrastructure. Bridges and inclines. I thought that he was going to allow me to... I thought he would let me cancel it and then just immediately... I mean, like, we just started it, game. See, this is one of the things I gotta say. No bit here, but just Sinvicta commentating. That's one of the things that I really hate about Animal Crossing is that the need... Like, in what game would I ever have to ask the game permission to cancel something and then have to wait an entire day before I can start a new project? Like, it should just be, oh, you don't want to build it there. Okay, cool. We just started it, so we'll just cancel it. Just pick somewhere else. You know what I mean? Like, it's little things like that with Animal Crossing that really do kind of irritate me a bit. And I totally 100% do not blame people for time skipping that stuff. Because that, to me, that's something that's a part of the game that definitely should be addressed. I mean, that and all the confirmation boxes and all the stuff that you got to go through. You know, there's... Animal Crossing is a great game. Don't get me wrong. But it is very counterintuitive when you start comparing it to like basic stuff. Like, I should be able to cancel that incline and then just make a new one today. I shouldn't have to wait an entire real day to do it, you know. And even though you always have the option to time skip ahead, of course, people don't want to do that. Like, I don't want to do that, you know. So I really hope that Nintendo does move forward with some improvements, like cutting down the dialogue boxes. I understand that something like that is kind of a core mechanic, and you should really be sure at what you are going to do or what you're not going to do with your projects and whatnot. But like, if somebody doesn't like it, they shouldn't be penalized an entire real day just because, oh, I actually don't like where that incline is now. Or doing what I did, which was I innocently thought that, oh, I can just cancel it because I just started the project today. And then I can just move it because I wanted to move it a little bit more to the right because I didn't want to have to, you know, squeeze my way past the construction. But it is what it is. It's Animal Crossing in a nutshell, and I hope that Nintendo improves it a lot because that kind of stuff gets irritating. I know that a lot of people have a lot of they've got a lot of problems with the multiplayer taking so long, and I, of course, after you saw that last the Island Party episode, of course, you know how you know my stance on that as well. So, you know, we'll see. Hopefully Nintendo will hear the complaints, and I know that I'm not the only one who feels that way. All right, let's go to this island here. We haven't had a good island in a while, Orville. I'm just saying. We haven't had a good one in a while. Got some pine trees here. I already see an incline. Okay, so we got some wildflowers. Oh yeah, I haven't shown you all the wildflowers yet. Wow, this is a wildflower-rich flyer? It's a wildflower-rich environment. This is in a bottle. Let's see what this is. What's up, Mega Builder? I was pumping iron, super sweaty, and I slipped in a DIY area. Okay, well, I already know this recipe, so thanks, bro. Appreciate it, bro. We got a lot of wildflowers here. Now, I would have been really interested had I not gotten a whole bunch of other wildflowers the other day here. So I'm not too interested in these flowers. This is absolutely not going to be a bug farming spot. Because I am not going up and down all these inclines. There's a water bug there. There's a lot of fish, I gotta say. We might do a little bit of fishing. If I can ever find my net and catch the stupid water bug. Definitely want to be getting all the non-native fruit here. 9:37 at the time of this recording, so I want to get all this stuff done. We want to be back home on my island in about 20 minutes, no later than 15 minutes, I'd say. Because obviously, again, I want to get to Nook's Cranny before it closes. Tell if the fish is aware of it. He is. Might be a guppy. If I catch one more piece of junk off this island, I'm just leaving. Two water bugs here, though, so that might keep me interested. It's interesting that it's only spawning water bugs. Also, apparently we just drew, like, a trash can island, so this, I guess, isn't worth fishing, but maybe it'd be worth fishing, or maybe it'd be worth water bug catching if that's all that they're spawning here. I mean, I don't hear any mole crickets, and I don't see any butterflies. Surely it's not all trash. Alright, so we're gonna be doing some fishing here. By fishing I mean some water bug fishing. I'm just gonna put away my fishing pole because Lord knows we're not gonna need that on this island. Yeah, those water bugs. And apparently water bugs sell pretty well. I didn't pay attention to how much they were selling for with Flick. Oh, one just respawned right here. So that's a nice surprise. At least we're getting something off of this island other than just, you know, crap. There's another water bug. Yeah, so we've got Water Bug Island here. This is interesting. Of course, you probably already knew this right by now, because I had to make this thumbnail interesting somehow. The Water Bug Island is This is a new one. I don't think I'm able to actually hit this one. Come over here, bro. I can't. You know I can't reach you over there. There we go. I'm gonna let the water bugs respawn real quick, and let's go shake some trees. If there's so much junk in the water, maybe we'll get something interesting out of the trees as well. So yeah, in all reality, though, this is a pretty good island. I'm glad that we got a themed island, you know? It's about freaking time. And the fact that we got a profitable one, if it is indeed going to be nothing but water bugs here, is going to be very, very nice. It's going to be a nice little balance boost. Now, unfortunately, because I canceled the incline, thinking that I could... that's a mistake you only make once, right? But thinking that I could just simply reset and nudge the location of that, we're going to have to wait before I can, you know, pay it off again. But we'll do that one on tomorrow's episode, I guess. Now, this also has me interested in possibly mining here. There we go. And possibly mining from these rocks, because if this is a rare island, which it definitely is, if it's nothing but water bugs here, then that means that we could potentially get some gold out of the rocks. Oh, I saw a water bug over here somewhere. And given the fact that those rocks are elevated, could mean that they have a better spawn rate of rare stuff in there. Right, come on, you know I can't reach over there. Come back over here. We have a lovely home over in Mosh Isle. We also only have 18 minutes, so. I'd like to leave here in like 15. Apparently, I can just jump over there. I didn't realize that was a possibility. Yeah, you can apparently just hop over rivers. Apparently. Okay. I did not know that. Who knew that? Put in the comments down below. Oh wait, sorry. I mean. Yeah, bros, put it in the comments down below if you knew that. Actually, the more better one would be.
Put it in the comments down below. Let me know if you knew about it. You can hop over rivers. Thanks. I'm your sod.
Come on, buddy. We got a nice big aquarium for you and all your friends. Bring all of them. It's a shame that I don't have Flick on my island, man. This would have been a ton of money. I mean, it's still going to be a ton of money, and I ain't complaining. But you can always make more. Where's he at? You're going to make me hop all the way over there. See this one over here. Come on, he's right there. I don't think I can sneak by that way. There we go. It's a little mischievous to be putting the water bug like out of my vision right there, game. I'm just saying. Oh, you think I can't go over there? Well, you are mistaken, Mr. Waterbug. Watch this. All right, so what's our inventory looking like? We got about 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. We got 13 water bugs left that we can catch, and that's pretty good. I could maximize it as well with our tools, or by me removing our tools here. Ooh, that's a big fish. This may be a turtle. This is too big to be a piece of junk, guaranteed. There's no way that this is a piece of junk. Unless there's a piece of junk I'm unfamiliar with. Thank you. Okay, while we wait for the bugs to load back in, let's go ahead and try to get some gold here. I'm running out of time. The only reason why I'm in a hurry. Now, obviously, I don't have to be in a hurry, because I can just put these in cages, I suppose. But I really don't feel like picking them all back up. I don't feel like putting them down and then picking them back up. Let's see. It may be too far away to stop me. Let's find out. No. There we go. Iron. Iron. Stone. Iron. 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 Play. Play. I'm looking for gold. I don't really need iron right now. The water bugs are more profit than iron is. But I would like to see some gold, though, if possible. We're doing good here. I saw you. Now we're catching them at a good rate. Yeah, this is gonna be good. This is a good spawn here. Thank you, Orville and Wilbur, for getting us a rare island. I'm only assuming it's rare. I don't know if it actually is rare. I've never seen this island before, and I'm totally 100% down with it because it seems like it's real good. But let me know in the comments if you have seen this island before and what other ones that you've seen in the game. I still have yet to come across Tarantula Island, even though I'm hoping that one day we will. Who knew that there was a Waterbug Island? Not me. Waterbug Island that's filled with trash. Which honestly doesn't like really surprise me, because like that's probably where water bugs would live. I don't keep the water bugs in high regard. I'm all too eager to sell them, let's put it that way. Look at this. This is just money. This is just free money right here. 948. Well, we'll be able to max out. Let's see. I do want this candle. I don't really care about the faucet door plate, because we've already learned that. And honestly, the coconuts aren't going to be worth more than the water bugs. We can catch four more. I really don't want to give up my tools. This is more than enough money than what we usually see from these mystery islands, so I'm happy with that. The only thing I would take other than a water bug here would be a couple gold nuggets, and I'm just not even going to worry about looking for them. There we go. We're looking good here, looking good. Could be one of the most profitable islands that we've gotten, and me losing that net also just gave us another free spot, so hey. Might be good. I don't know if there's one there or not. I'm just kind of spitballing here. There's one. Just gonna check this corner here. There's not. Okay, so there's another one in that corner there. Oh no, I made all the trash swim away. What? Apparently that was it for our rod? Or our net, I mean. Alright, well that's enough, I guess. We could have only caught two more anyway, so I guess I'll take some of the nuggets and I'll take some of the clay. And we will call it a good day here. But yeah, we got an actual legit rare island for once. And I know I can buy another. Well, I guess I could make another net here. There's enough tree branches here. Let's just do that. We don't need clay. We definitely don't need iron. I'm not going to bother upgrading the net. I'm just going to pick up 5 branches and make a net real quick. There we go. There we go. This would be the most profitable 5 branches that we've made in quite a while. Now let's craft us a net real quick. Then let's go ahead and equip it. Okay, let's finish off the profit getting here. Again, I don't know if there's one there or not. Just swinging blindly right now. There's one. You know, something I noticed that it's... The nets swing at a different speed. That's interesting. I've never noticed that before. Yep, we're going to swap it, and we're going to swap it out for the net. Or apparently I can't do that. We'll swap it out for a fishing pole, I guess. And then I'll pick up the fishing rod. Swap it out for the net. Because I don't care about a flimsy net. Okay, let's go back to the Nook Twins and call it a day here. Let's see what kind of profits we're looking at as we end this episode. Again, if you are enjoying this episode, make sure you click the like button, everybody. It holds true on the Animal Crossing series just as much as the Isaac series. Liking, commenting, all that kind of good stuff. It is the best way to support your favorite channels. Not only myself, but of course any content creator channel that you have here on YouTube. If you want to see more of this content, that's the best way to ensure that becoming a reality. All right, let's go talk to the Crook Twins over here. Don't forget, later today, those of you who did not know, I also do a collaboration series with Northern Lion for GeoGuessr. And that'll be coming up within about half an hour, just under half an hour from now. I want to sell. Let's see what our final prices are here for Waterbug Island. I'm only going to sell the waterbugs, because that's all we have to sell anyway. How many waterbugs is this? That's going to be, let's see, 12, 24, it looks like 36. My count's correct, just by eyeballing it. Be 60,000 bells. Dude, that's actually one of the most profitable, easiest to work with mystery islands that we've gotten. So look at that, 100 G's in the bank, and I could have almost paid off that that incline that I should have just let done. But hey, again, that's a mistake you only learn only once. So pro tip of the day, don't try to cancel something on the same day that you put it down, because you're going to have to wait a day for it to happen. So thank you for watching, everybody. Again, I appreciate all the support here on the Animal Crossing series. If you enjoyed this video, remember what I said earlier. Please let me know in the comments down below. Comments, they count a whole lot. Likes count a whole lot. And of course, subscribe to the channel here if you have not subscribed already. Welcome all 150,000 subscribers here on the channel in the Mosh Pit. Thank you all very much for the support, not only on this series, but all the other series that I do here on the channel. Hope you had a great start to your week. And as always, I will see you all next time for more Animal Crossing New Horizons. Until then, so long, everybody.